Hi students, today we will continue the aldehydes, ketones, chemical properties in the nucleophilic addition reactions. In this we will see the reaction with Grignard reagent. Here a reaction with the Grignard reagent. The reaction of Grignard reagent with aldehydes and ketones, we studied somewhere, no? Where we studied this reaction? Have you remembered? Yes, we studied in the previous chapter. Just if I give the reaction, you can get easily C-R, C double bond O. Here it is R dash, or we can take this one as a H, means an aldehyde or a ketone is taken. To this we are adding R, suppose we are taking R, and this is R dash MZX, a Grignard reagent is taken. Generally in a Grignard reagent alkyl group, here it acts as a nucleophile. So this acts as a nucleophile, and this is Mg plus 2, and this is minus 1. Okay, and here the nucleophilic center, because of the shift of this pair of electrons on this oxygen, due to the more electron negativity, it gets positive and it is getting negative. So the alkyl group will attacks on the carbonyl carbon. And the remaining Mg plus 2 will be added to this oxygen. So what is formed here is RC, R hydrogen, and first an alkyl group is added from the Grignard reagent, and the next one is O, Mg, X is formed. This is intermediate, and this is undergoing to hydrolysis. So in the hydrolysis process, here the H and here OH group is added, then, so here OH group is added, then the product is R, C, R, R, H, and here one more R, and here we are getting OH plus, what is the other compound, Mg, OH, X. So what is this compound? Carbon having OH group means it is alcohols. So what are the main products of Grignard reagent reaction with aldehydes or ketones means? They are alcohols. So alcohols preparation, we used this reaction in alcohols preparation methods. If you think about the preparation methods of alcohols, this is the best method. And in this reaction, suppose first one I am taking, in the place of two alkyl groups or R groups, I am taking only HCOH. This is we gave clearly, it is called as formaldehyde. It is known as formaldehyde. When formaldehyde is taken, and this is a alkyl group is CH3. For example, this is CH3 and this is MgBr. Then what is the product? So first what is formed means same. Here this is CH3 minus carbon ion, Mg plus 2 minus 1. And the carbon ion attacks on this carbonyl carbon. And here H and here CH. And this is CH3, and here we are having OMZBr, and furtherly it undergoes to hydrolysis. By the hydrolysis process, you will get here the bond dissociation occur, H and OH, and so finally H, and here it is H and CH3 and OH. Or we can write simply in a condensed formula, that is CH3, CH2, OH. What is that? CH3, CH2OH. Yes, CH3, CH2OH is called as ethyl alcohol. Ethyl alcohol. It is a primary alcohol. Plus MgOHBr is formed. I am writing here MgOH and Br. Okay, that is a other product. So what is formed here? When formaldehyde is used with a Grignard reagent, it forms ethyl alcohol or a primary alcohols. And suppose second one, any other aldehyde is taken. Any other aldehyde means here it may be CH3 group and here it is C double bond O and this is H. And here this is called as acetaldehyde. Common name of this compound is acetaldehyde. When acetaldehyde is reacting with a Grignard reagent, MgBr, then again same methyl group adds on this carbon. So here we are getting CH3 and CH, and here another methyl group newly added, and OMgBr followed by hydrolysis gives CH3 and CH and OH and CH3, or you can simply write in a condensed form like CH3, CH, OH and CH3. This is a secondary alcohol, or it is isopropyl alcohol is formed. So a secondary alcohol, isopropyl alcohol, is formed. So any other aldehydes gives secondary alcohols. And next, third one we are taking, that is a ketone, CH3 C CH3. This is a ketone. When we are taking a ketone, I'm writing again here, this is a CH3 C double bond and this is a CH3 ketone, and this reacts with a Grignard reagent CH3 MgBr, and first it is forming CH3 and here again CH3 and again another CH3 added from the methyl Grignard reagent, and here we will get OMgBr. And now this is followed by the hydrolysis, then it is forming CH3 C CH3 and another CH3 and OH. What is that alcohol? This is a tertiary butyl alcohol. This is a tertiary alcohol. So tertiary butyl alcohol, it is commonly called as tertiary butyl alcohol. So Grignard reagent reacts with only formaldehyde followed by hydrolysis gives primary alcohol. Grignard reagent reacts with any other aldehydes, even aromatic aldehyde also you can take. Any other aldehyde with the Grignard reagent will gives, followed by hydrolysis gives secondary alcohols. And ketones reacts with the Grignard reagent will gives tertiary alcohols finally. So this reaction is a common reaction you can use to observe the products, or you can write simply. So formaldehyde reacts with Grignard reagent or MgX followed by hydrolysis gives primary alcohols, and all other aldehydes with the same Grignard reagent followed by hydrolysis will give secondary alcohols. All ketones with the Grignard reagent followed by hydrolysis gives tertiary alcohols. So this is a reaction with a Grignard reagent. Here Grignard reagent acts as a nucleophile alkyl group of Grignard reagent acts as a nucleophile. And in Grignard reagent reaction with water or reaction with acetylene, that Grignard reagent alkyl group will act as a base. So Grignard reagent will show mainly two types of reactions. Grignard reagent alkyl carbon ion as a base, Grignard reagent alkyl carbon ion as a nucleophile reactions. Okay, we can't say always base, we can't say always nucleophile, because alkyl group attacking on the carbonyl carbon atom, then it acts as a nucleophile. Nucleophiles only attacks on the carbon atom. Base will attack on proton. Means, I will give simple one relation or one equation. Here, RMGX is present, RMGX. And here, we are having HOH, whatever it may be, we have water. Then what happens? Here, this is alkyl carbon ion, we are telling. This is abstracting, or it is removing the hydrogen from this. And this bond dissociate, then what is formed here? RH means alkyl group or alkyl carbon ion attracting the proton or attacking on the proton. So here Grignard reagent alkyl carbon ion acts as a base, and here it acts as a nucleophile. Okay. Next one is reaction with water. Here, aldehydes and ketones reacts with water, but here the water is a weak nucleophile. H2O is a neutral and weak nucleophile. Please remember, first and important thing, H2O having two lone pairs is a weak neutral. Weak neutral nucleophile. So the rate of reaction is very less when we are taking directly water and an aldehyde and a ketone. To improve the rate of reaction, rate of reaction is less because of weak nucleophile. To increase rate of reaction, acid or base catalyst is used. Means the reaction of water in the presence of H+ or in the presence of OH- we can conduct, then the reaction will be very fast. Okay, how this will be very fast? First we will see aldehydes and ketones. For example, here I am taking aldehyde. For example, aldehyde is reacting with acid catalyzed. Here acid catalyzed means H+ is present. We are taking H+. So here what is present? Two lone pairs. Then what happens? Two lone pairs means one lone pair will attract this H+ ion. And so what form? RCH. And here double bond O, and having a positive charge and one lone pair and H. Means this oxygen is now having one lone pair only, and oxygen having positive charge. Because of positive charge on oxygen atom, what happened? Immediately to try to get the octet configuration by neutral charge by gaining of these electrons. Means carbonyl group positive negative formation is required. When positive charge on carbon is present, then H2O lone pair will be attacked on this carbon. And this is arised when we use a H+ ion. And then what happens? Immediately, this is shifting into RCH and here O and having two lone pairs and H. And then what is forming? Here carbon is getting positive charge. Whenever it is getting positive charge, immediately the next one is nucleophile. So nucleophile, what is a nucleophile? Here, water. Water is a nucleophile. This nucleophile will attack on this oxygen. So what is formed? RCH. And here already OH group is present. Okay, this is old OH group. Okay, and next, newly what we are getting? Water molecule. Water molecule means it is a OH and having positive charge and having a lone pair. Because one lone pair it is given for the carbon. So I will write simply to identify easily OH2 and a lone pair. And this oxygen is having now positive charge, because that gives a lone pair to form a bond with carbon. Now, to get neutrality, it is losing a proton. This hydrogen is losing, as like this, normally. Here, if you want to write that, if you remove the hydrogen, or you can see easily, this bond electrons are shifted onto this, and this is the second hydrogen. So, what is formed? RCH, and here already OH group is present, and this is second OH group now we are getting, okay, with the two lone pairs. What is the final product? A zemdiol. So zemdiol is formed as a final product. So what are the final products in this reaction? Zemdiols. So, zemdiols are formed by the reaction of water in the presence of acid or in the presence of base also, same thing happens. Okay? So, this is acid-catalyzed reaction of water. No need of going for mechanism. How you can write simply means, you just remove the oxygen and add two OH groups. Okay? So, how we can write the products means, RCH, double bond O plus H2O in the presence of H plus, then what is formed is a diol, OH and OH and H. Two bonds are present with oxygen, you remove that bond and add the OH groups. Okay, or here you can simply remember like H plus H2O molecule means water present, H plus and OH minus is present, H plus is added to this carbon, for example, OH minus is added to this carbon, then this bond dissociate, one bond, second bond will be there, so you will get COH and here you will get COH, two OH groups we are getting. So this is aldehyde to zemdiol formation in acid catalyzed reaction of H2O. Okay, in base catalyzed also same thing happens, a slight change we can observe. So, this is final reaction, how we can write. Next, I will give the second type, base catalyzed. The second type is base catalyzed reaction of water. Base catalyzed means what is present here? Base means OH minus. So, OH minus means we will get a different process. You will get a different process. See here. OH minus means already it is having a lone pair of electrons. So it will attack on the carbonyl carbon because it is a strong base. Then this pair of electrons shifts onto this. So here R, C, H and here it is OH. And here it is getting O minus. Now it is O minus. And then here H2O. Here H2O means it has a H plus ion. That H plus ion will be given to this because it is alkoxide ion. Alkoxide is a strong base. So it can abstract or absorb proton from this easily. So you will get OH, and finally one OH minus from this H2O is released. That is base catalyzed reaction of water. Okay, anyhow, acid catalyzed or base catalyzed reaction occurs mainly because if only water is taken, it is a weak nucleophile and a neutral nucleophile. So to improve the reactivity, we are taking either acid or base as a catalyst. Okay, and one more thing here we need to remember is which is more reactive and which is a factor, which factor influences the reactivity towards water. Okay, see these three reactions. In these three reactions, first one is formaldehyde reacting with water in acid presence, or acetaldehyde water, acetone water. So what is the product here is H, we said now CO group will be added with the two OH groups. So this is the first product. Second, again CH3COOH, and here OH and H. Diol, gemdiol. Again, here also we can get CH3COOH and OH and CH3. In these three compounds or products, which is more means this is 99.9% and this is only 58% and this is 0.2%. Please see here formaldehyde to diol formation. Formaldehyde diol formation is 99.9% possible. Whereas acetaldehyde to this acetaldehyde diol is 58% only. This is a reversible reaction actually. Okay, and in this reaction if you take, this formation is 0.2% only. Why? What happened? In these two factors mainly influences the formation of diols from aldehydes and ketones on reaction with water. So which factors influences mainly? Means the first factor is steric reasons. Steric reasons. The second factor is same, electronic reasons. Electronic reasons. As we said for the beginning of reactivity of aldehydes and ketones, same factor will be here. Steric reasons means here there is no crowding. No crowding, so the formed OH group will be easily formed. It becomes a tetrahedral manner easily and will become stable. But in this what happened? One side methyl group is present. Because of this methyl group, there is a repulsion. This methyl group and OH groups repel. They repel each other, and so the stability of this diol will be very less. And in this two methyl groups are there. These two methyl groups are bulky. So because of this bulky methyl groups, the repulsion between these groups increases. So it becomes very unstable. So that what happens? This diol, ketones forming a diol, will be always less stable. Okay. This is first reason, steric reasons. Okay. In this three, suppose I am taking one reaction, second reaction, third reaction, rate of 1 is greater than rate of 2 is greater than rate of 3. Okay, sometimes they may ask rate of reaction. You just remember the yield also, percentage of product. Okay, that is first reason. Second reason I am taking, I am just changing this one. Suppose here it is having CF3 and this is having CCl3, or it is suppose CH3, for example CH3, and this is CF3 and this is CCl3. Okay, this side also you can write CCl3 or you can write only H. By just comparing this we can take. So then what happens here? It is CH3 and this is CF3 and here it is having CCl3. Okay, CCl3 H only present. Okay, this is the product here we are getting. Then tell me what is the product? Which product is more stable or whose rate of reaction is more. Here this is 1 again, this is 2 and this is 3. If you observe this, rate of second reaction is more than rate of third reaction is more than rate of first one. Why? Because it's simply electronic reasons. What is this group? Here this group is what type of group? It is a plus I group. Here this is a minus I group. This is a minus I group. In this fluorine, fluorine is more electronegative than chlorine. Electronegativity, if you compare, fluorine is more electronegative than chlorine. So whenever more electronegative, what happens? It forms a hydrogen bond easily. This is forming a hydrogen bond. The most stable, only one stable chloral hydrate is present. You can check because of its minus I effect. Okay, chlorine, and here it is a CH, OH. Here also Cl only, sorry. Here it is also OH. I wrote this compound as like this only. This compound is called as chloral hydrate. Very, very important. Please remember, a molecule in which chlorine atom shows hydrogen bonding is only one compound, this compound only. In this compound, because of its high minus I effect and because of the OH groups adjacently present, it forms a hydrogen bonding and stable. Chloral hydrate is stable. Even though 2 OH groups is present on same carbon, it is stable. Why means? Because of this hydrogen bonding and because of minus I effect groups. Okay. So, whenever the minus I effect groups are present, minus I groups, if present, then they increase the stability. Whenever plus I groups are present, simply plus I groups are present, then they decrease the stability. So please remember, the stability of product depends upon steric reasons and electronic reasons. One steric reasons, if steric problem increases, steric effect is more, means steric hindrance is more, as previously I gave, then the stability decreases and so the product stability decreases. Whenever electronic reasons, minus I groups, plus I groups. If electron withdrawing groups or minus I groups are present, then it will be stabilized and so the product with electron withdrawing groups is more stable than the aldehyde or ketone taken with electron donating groups. Okay, that is reaction with water. And these diols can be easily converted back into aldehydes and ketones by just hydrolysis in the presence of aqueous mineral acids. They can be reconverted into aldehydes and ketones, or aldehydes, ketones can be regenerated from the diols to aldehydes and ketones by treatment with hydrolysis, aqueous mineral acids hydrolysis. Aqueous mineral acids on treatment with these diols gives back the aldehydes and ketones.